Day and night, I toss and turn, I keep stressing my mind. I look for peace, but see I don't attain. What I need for keeps this silly game we play. Now look at this.
What up, YouTube? It's your boy JohnLuke07 2000. Today we're gonna have another deck tech. This is another EDH deck tech. Switched up my general from last time, and right now I'm running Oona, Queen of the Fae. So this is my Oona, the Queen of the Fae build. Ooh, look at that sleeve. So much Oona. So yeah, we're gonna talk about Oona. So I hope you guys enjoy my build. As always, if you have suggestions, please. Put them in the comments. I will say this deck is not super monetary driven. It's pretty budget, but I like it. So, you know, what can you do? Starting off with the lands, the best dual land ever, Command Tower. More dual lands, Underground River. Good one. Drowned Catacomb. Dimir Aqueduct. Dreadship Reef, Jawar Owl Refuge. For some colorless and land destruction, we have Tectonic Edge, Strip Mine, and Ghost Quarters. These are used to get rid of pesky lands. For some blue lands, I have Sea to Synod and Halimar Depths. Halimar for filtering, obviously. The seat for if I need to tutor for it. It's easy to tutor with Trinket Mage or Fabricate. Couple Terramorphics. Temple, Reliquary, and Urza's Factory are my colorless lands. They're good. Basics. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 islands. Yeah, easy enough. 10 swamps. Planeswalkers, I run 3. One is a proxy, but I can borrow it from a friend, and that one is Jace the Mind Sculptor. My other two are Liliana Vess and Soren Markov. Before I tell you anything more about this deck, I wanted to say that the reason I built this deck is because we're having a bit of a douche problem. So if there's some stuff that you might consider douchey, like Soren Markov, it's because we're trying to make this guy understand that it's not fun to play cards like him. So Phyrexian Area is next card. Counterbalance, which combos, of course, with Sensei's Divining Top, which I have in here. Mind Unbound. Sweet card. Lets you draw a bunch. And Propaganda. These are all my enchantments. Artifacts. Now, artifacts come in a couple of different varieties in this deck. Some are for mana production. There's a couple that are just for combos. Or for... Just utility. The mana ones are Lotus Bloom, Gauntlet of Power, Cage Sun, Everflowing Chalice, Dimir Signet, Mana Vault. This is a proxy, but I don't have one. I need one of these guys. So if anybody has a Mana Vault, they'd be willing to trade, let me know. Talisman of Dominance, Soul Ring. For Graveyard Hate, I run Relic of Progenitus. I actually run the Boots and Lightning Greaves. Sensei's Top to counter with counterbalance and just overall goodness. Oblivion Stone, because every once in a while you need an extra board wipe. And Icecrown Scepter for combos with instants. Speaking of instants, we're going to go right into them. Starting with Counterspell, a great card to go on Icecrown Scepter. Shred Memory, I'm using this mostly for Transmute, but it does have good implications with the actual ability. Brainstorm, Mystical Teachings, a great tutor card. Dort. This was a suggestion on my Urtai deck, and I liked it so much in there, I put it in here. It's been working good. Blue Sun, Disrupting Shoal, another suggestion from 2 and 8 MTG. Rewind, Mystical Tutor, sweet card. Doomblade, yeah, you like that? No, I didn't think so. I like it. A Terror, and a Oona, he's right there. Thought that was cool. Factor Fiction, obvious. Boomerang, good. And Muddle the Mixture. This is slowly becoming one of my favorite cards in the deck, just because of its versatility. If you can't, if you don't want to counter something, you can always transmute it. Next, we're going to go to sorceries. We have Ancestral Visions, Exsanguinate. I'll talk more about that in a second. Compulsive Research, Treasure Hunt, Consumed Spirit, which is also part of something I want to talk about. Life's Finale is one of my favorite sweepers in this format. Just because one-on-one, if there's a guy picking on you, this makes him mad usually. Recall, Preordained Ponder, great cards, and Fabricate. I think I passed my third X spell. Yeah, I already talked about it. But the X spells are for an infinite combo, my X spells are Exsanguinate, Consumed Spirit, and Blue Sun Zenith. And Exsanguinate's the best one. But I actually did a 56 life gain Exsanguinate, putting me up to 80, and I lost the next turn. Last time we were playing, it was a lot of fun. I run two artifact creatures. One is Steel Hellkite, because he's pretty sweet. I mean, I think he's pretty underrated. The other one is part of the only infinite combo in this deck, which is Pilipala. And then I'll show you what he combos with in a second. Just let me find it. Here it is. Grand Architect. So you use a blue to make him blue, and then he can tap himself to make 2 mana, and use that 2 mana to use his untap ability to make a blue. Okay, so that blue floats, and you tap him again to make 2 blue, and use the 2 blue that you make by tapping him to untap him and make another blue, or black, whatever. And you can do that as many times you want with your X spells to get infinite mana. So that's what's that all about. I have another infinite combo with Cage Sun and Gauntlets of Power with Palancron. This is a proxy, of course. I don't have a Palancron yet, but I'm looking to get one. Drift of Phantasms, Transmute, Teferi is just legit. Frost Titan is pretty awesome. Aether Mage is awesome tutoring ability. But, you know, if you play against somebody with the Slivers and you really want that tempo, this guy gets there. Metamorph is so crazy utility. He's extremely good. I kept the Stormtide Leviathan in just for the mode effect. I like him a lot in the late game. Shuts down the board until you can get your combo in. Dimir Infiltrator is a 1-3 unblockable. You're usually transmuting, but, you know, if you want to play him, you can. Chance of Aspires for the Memory Plunder ability. Fae the Untouchable. There's a joke when I'm playing this deck and my Urtai deck that I chill in the cut in multiplayer games. That's what we call it when somebody's just chilling out, doesn't mess with anybody. And I'm the master of chilling in the cut. So what I'll do is I'll play Fade from my hand with the boots in play, put the boots on and kill somebody. So I chill in the cut until I need to kill someone, and then I kill them. Muldrifter, Cardjaw, Artisan, Value, Psychotog. When the game gets really late and you have a bunch of cards in your hand from your Blue Sun Zenith and stuff like that, Psychotog is a cool way to kill somebody. Trigamage, really like that utility. And Shouldred. Shouldred is awesome. This card is really good. If you haven't played with this card yet, you should play with this card because it's really good. So that's my Oona deck. By no means is it perfect. It definitely needs, you know, some more tinkering. So basically, the reason I made this deck is some kid, he's about 15. Everyone else is really chill and casual at our shop, and this guy was being a douche. So, you know, he's playing Natural Order Progenitus in his deck and stuff. And other stuff like that. And that's just not fun. It's not the way we play EDH at our shop. So we all built kind of douche decks to play him. We're all going to gang up on them tomorrow. we have a few rules. We have a league, a EDH league. And one of our rules is, you know, whoever tutored the most loses a point. And we have a point system for, you know, who gets promos and stuff like that. So, I just disregard it. I'm like, you know what? Fuck it. I don't care about points. About losing that one point. I'm going to get my points back from killing everyone. Because you get a point for knocking someone out of the pod. And you also get a point for winning the match. So, yeah, that's what I went for. I said, I'm just going to tutor as much as I can. And I'm going to get sweet cards and kill people. So, yeah. Palancron is something I have to pick up. I'm trying to get one from 2N8 MTG. If not, I'm going to try to get one from one of my buddies. That might have one. You guys, I don't know about you. I'm really getting tired of these daily videos. They're just kind of a hassle. Okay. Well, you know, I'm going to keep doing them until Mana Shark stops. Because I'm not one to lose a bet. But it's going to be annoying. It's already annoying, I'm not going to lie. But yeah, I'm making videos for you guys. If you have any suggestions on how I can improve it, please comment down below. And a big shout out to 2N8 MTG for helping me out so much in my Urtai deck. If you want to give me some help on this one, that'd be awesome too. Things that I've noticed, I noticed the counterbalance isn't as good in EDH because everyone's playing like 6 or 7 cost things. It's not like Legacy where they're only playing 1, 2, and 3. I don't know if you guys have seen it, but like the hype around Modern is insane right now. It's so crazy. Like, if you guys want some trading tips at your local FNMs, trade away your Ravlance and trade away, I don't know, Bob right now is 50. A Dark Confidence is 50. I would probably get rid of him. Tarmogoyf is back up at 100. Go ahead and get rid of those. So yeah, all the cards that are super high, you want to swap those out for, stuff that it's going to be stable, you know, Bob might stay stable, but you never know. It could go down. So that's your choice. I think if you have any pimp, if you have any pimp cards, if you have any like pimp dual lands or pimp Bobs or Tarmogoyfs, this is the time to get rid of them. You're gonna get a lot of value out of them, and that's the whole point of trading for value. So yeah, guys, that's gonna be it for today. I'm done talking about Magic. Tomorrow I get to play Magic, so hopefully that'll be fun. Of course it will, because playing Magic is always fun. Yeah, that's going to do it, guys. Please, like I said, leave a comment below. Give me a thumbs up. It always makes me feel good when I see I got a bunch of thumbs ups. I would tell you to favorite the video, but, you know, it doesn't really matter. if you like it a lot, favorite it. So, yeah. Thanks, guys. Thanks again. I appreciate it. And everybody have a wonderful day. But for right now, until tomorrow, guys, it is your boy, John Luke 07 2000. Peace.